Well, there you have it. Logan Diggs has picked Notre Dame after some back and forth here over the last couple weeks. It's been a wild, wild back and forth. So just a little backstory. Logan Diggs signed with Notre Dame back in December. Wanted to do today, the deal today, wanted to sign with his teammates, wanted to do this ceremony with his teammates. And then obviously LSU got involved and made it a little challenging for him. So it was a wild up and down affair, but Notre Dame was able to get it done. And this is big. This is big for Notre Dame. So this is a really big pickup for the staff. They needed two running backs in this class. Flat out, they needed two running backs in this class. When you consider the fact that, number one, Notre Dame lost Jameer Smith from the roster, Jafar Armstrong isn't coming back. And if we're being honest, the reality is, if Kyren Williams has another year like he had this past season, there's a chance that he is going to not be at Notre Dame a whole lot longer. So they needed a second back in this class, and Logan Diggs is a very talented player. As we talk here about what this means for Notre Dame, going to have some highlights rolling here about Logan Diggs. Look, here's the thing you got to understand about putting together a running back group. You can't just have necessarily five guys to do the same exact thing. You need guys that complement each other. And especially if you're going to get into situations where you're going to start using more two back sets. So Notre Dame signed Audric Estime in December, and he's a talented back, big thumper, nimble feet, kind of a big play guy. No question about it. Talented runner. And he brings a certain downhill skill set to the table. Not a great, not used often in the pass game. The thing I like about Logan Diggs is he's also a big back, as you see in that clip right there. Big physical guy, 6 foot, 200 pounds, talented player, plays against very good competition. You can see that he can run between the tackles, but the thing I like about Logan Diggs is he can also play outside. He's a guy that can run outside zone. He can make those one cuts. He can stretch the defense. He's patient. He's got really good feet. And he's very good in the pass game, and that's a big part of this as well. Both of these guys, Logan Diggs and Audric Estime, are guys that can be every down backs. They can be guys that carry the ball every time. They, you know, 20 times a game, 20 touches a game, can hammer you between the tackles. But also, they can be guys that if you give them a crease, they can make big plays. I mean, if you want comparisons, if you're someone who likes comparisons, they're both similar to Tony Jones Jr., but they're both faster than Tony Jones Jr. And the fact of the matter is, last year, despite playing behind a line that wasn't as good and was banged up, Tony Jones Jr. was on pace for 1,000 yards had he not got hurt, and his 5.9 yards per carry was better than what we saw from Kyren Williams this year, who was at 5.3 yards per carry. So this is a big pickup for Notre Dame, and being able to go down to Louisiana, identify this kid early. And kudos to Terry Joseph, who I've been critical of as a recruiter. But Terry Joseph was actually the guy that got this job done early on and got him to commit to the class. LSU was sort of his dream school. They got involved late. But Notre Dame was able to fend that off and add him to the class. And it really completes what is arguably the best offensive class of the Brian Kelly tenure. There's a couple classes that you could maybe say compete with it. But what I love about this class is they hit all the right notes. You got a big-time quarterback. You got two outstanding running backs, in my opinion, that fit your system. You got two tight ends. You got three really good wide receivers, two really excellent receivers, another third complimentary player that's got some talent. And you signed a strong five-man offensive line class. So there's no position you look at and say, boy, that wasn't great. There are positions that you say are at least very least good. And then there's obviously parts that are excellent. So this was an excellent, excellent offensive class for Notre Dame. And Logan Diggs was a must-get. There was a lot of talk about, well, you know, with Audric Estime, they really don't need him. They needed him in this class. This was a need. This was a guy that they had to get. You cannot go into a season with four healthy running backs. I've heard people say, well, you know, they have four running backs. You can't go into the season with four running backs. Number one, we don't know what COVID is going to be like next year as far as, are they going to have the same testing policies? If you test positive, you're out. If they do, we saw this year, there was a time during fall camp that Notre Dame was down to one running back. If that happens during the season, you're in trouble. And you fewer players, plus there's injuries. You know, guys get hurt. You need five running backs, and you need five talented running backs. And by getting Logan Diggs, you get that. Plus, Logan Diggs and Audric Estime can also both play as freshmen if the need arises. So you now have five running backs next year that can all play next year and be effective players. And as you see there, how good Logan Diggs is in the pass game. But this was a big pickup for Notre Dame. And it's also big for the future, because if Kyron Williams does have another big season and goes pro, you're in great shape. You'll see Bo Flemister will probably be in his last year next year. But you'll be in great shape because you'll have Chris Tyree plus now these two freshmen. And then any freshman you're bringing in will be fourth, fifth on the depth chart unless they can then work their way up, which is really where you want to be. So landing Logan Diggs was really, really big for Notre Dame. And landing him with Audric Estime was huge. So they got Logan Diggs early. They were able to get Estime late, who had a monster senior season. So being able to put those two guys together in the same class was big time for Notre Dame. This was a must get situation. And I like the fact that they both also complement Chris Tyree very well. I think the thing we learned about Chris Tyree this year is that he is a home run waiting to happen. But I don't know if Chris Tyree's ever going to be a guy you want touching the ball 25 times a game. You add these two thumpers to go with him. Now they can handle some of that dirty work. And then Chris Tyree can be that change of pace hammer where you bring these guys in and they're hammering the defense. They're running between the tackles. And then you got to deal with, you know, Chris Tyree coming in with his 4.3 speed and he's going to take it to the house. So you look at where the running back depth chart has come the last couple seasons. It's a very, very strong group. The running back depth chart not that long ago was considered a question mark for Notre Dame. It was considered a position that you looked at and you said, boy, I don't know where this position is going. The recruiting there during the Archer Denson era was subpar. And what Notre Dame has been able to do in recent seasons is replenish the depth chart in very, very impressive fashion. And Logan Diggs is obviously a big part of that. So this is a big pickup for Notre Dame, big get for Notre Dame, and adds to another class. Another strong offensive class, and really tops things off. And we'll have a podcast coming out here later tonight with myself and Vince D'Addario, where we will break down the entire offensive class. We already have the entire defensive class broken down. You can check that out on all of our podcasts, also on YouTube, and you'll be able to see kind of what we have there. So we'll have a full breakdown of the class. This is a really, really excellent class. And honestly, it would have been a good class no matter what. If Logan Diggs picked LSU, it still would have been a good class. But now you cannot say that Notre Dame failed to meet its numbers needs at any position. They now met their numbers needs at every position. But more importantly, they met their needs with talented, talented players. So a big pickup for Notre Dame. Logan Diggs is now officially in the Notre Dame class, joins a backfield that has Audric Estime and Tyler Buckner. And of course, a very outstanding wide receiver group, strong tight ends, and a strong offensive line class. So Notre Dame was able to finish their class off in impressive fashion. Make sure you're locked into irishbreakdown.com for the latest. We will have more analysis of the entire class, on the entire offensive class. And in the meantime, make sure you check out our defensive breakdown. We have all of the position groups are now up on YouTube. We have the entire breakdown up on our podcast page, which you can also find at irishbreakdown.com. So thanks for joining us, and we will talk to you again here very, very soon.